Zongjie creates landscapes suspended between the real and the ideal dimensions imbued with intimacy and meditative tones. For him, painting is a thinking process. While completing any piece of work, every decision he makes is in favor of nothing but his own growth. It is never to prove any theory, to make any statement in order to progress onto anything else on purpose. Slowly but constantly, he gradually removes layer by layer any excess information. After pain and doubt, his paintings have become more abstract, and he has turned them into the meeting point of pure substance and elusive visions. Light plays a key role in these abstractions, dominating the surface and becoming the landscape itself. Influenced by the work of Barnett Newman and the principles of minimalism, Chen Jiahua works with acrylic on canvas to produce abstract geometric compositions that demonstrate the flawless minimalism. In her paintings, where large patches of colors are delimited by thin contrasting lines, the artist seeks to challenge the easy balance of a traditional canvas by delineating large areas of solid color with stark borders and contrasting lines. Sensitive to the impact of space, Chen Jiahua's works create subtle optical illusions, challenging the physical limitations of the flat medium on which she paints to suggest a third dimension to her pieces. Marco Mazzucconi is a brilliant inventor of forms. Since 1985, he was a recognized promise of the young Italian art. Along with few others of his generation, Marco represents the prototype of the global artist who has basically erased the history to adopt geography, who has finally abdicated the utopian and unrealizable presumption of truth in favor of a simple I like it. The body of new works presented here is Essere non qui, being not here, as we are going to describe them through the words of Marco himself. Desire to be puzzled, to get lost, not physically or chemically, rather to get lost in an image, a scene, focusing on a tiny detail, a few pixels, and then enlarging it, stretching these pixels to reform an image, a new apparently abstract reality without any focus. I repeat this simple Photoshop process on a canvas stretched on the cylinder of a large lathe, spreading the oil paint in large patches, and then I apply the brush in a single, very long pass, which, thanks to the mechanical movement of the cylinder itself over time, it amalgamates the entire surface of the painting and brings me back to the longed-for condition of being not here. Jiger's art practice is characterized by his idea to play with defacement and vandalization, making use of the oil color. the spray paint, and the rough interventions on the canvases, which he uses to burn and, in some cases, even to cut. Giger's artwork springs from a painted canvas where Kreutz copies the Flemish and post-Renaissance masters. Apparently without a logical scheme, the artist applies the dense oil color layer by layer, not hiding, rather mystifying the classical backdrop. The artwork hereby explored the concept of failure in the visual dialogue between outer surface and the inner content, between past and present, figuration and abstraction. Inspiration to create an artwork from my surroundings, usually from my culture as a Balinese. There are a lot of traditional and religious rituals. They are the source of my inspiration. After I get an idea, I make a sketch and discuss it with my fellow artist until my idea is ready to be translated into an artwork.
Saya Gusti Gurahamdiantara, saya lagi duduk di depan karya saya yang terbaru dengan judul Infinity Life. Di sini aku menekankan bagaimana aku menggambar melukis garis. Jadi aku memperlakukan garis itu, mewarnai garis itu, mengasih efek garis itu. Jadi ini semua tentang garis. Mulai dari tradisi orang Bali yang mencari awal dari sebuah generasi, mencari dasar sebuah peradaban, budayaan, sehingga kita melakukan hal-hal yang dilakukan orang sebelum kita. Seperti garis itu sudah digariskan, menarik kata-kata. Garis itu garis yang sudah digariskan.
Since his childhood, Rangaputra has been interested in painting. Painting is pure pleasure for him. He started to paint when he was at the senior high school. Influenced by some important exhibitions in Yogyakarta, to date, Ranga has already joined plenty of shows in his country and also been awarded in 2012. Anselm Kiefer, George Baselitz, Basquiat, Jean Dubuffet, Tapie are some of legend artists, as he likes to call them, that have inspired him. Most of Ranga's artworks bring out his interest for daily issues such as personal routines. Monochrome colors are his typical landmark, whereas colors bring the nuance of deep reflection. Ranga likes to play with texture and explore new materials such as asphalt, car paint, and spray. The Indonesian street artist Farhan Siki reflects about the pop culture of the 21st century exploring textual elements, collecting logos, brands, and symbols of mass culture in order to prepare them on canvas, charging them with hyperbolic attributes and parody. In his artworks, the urban experience and the ever-increasing consumerist culture we encounter in our daily life is crashed in a loud splash of colors, satirizing the contemporary art system that has become, for some artists, a start system. The recognition of labels and traditional art subjects at once brings a feeling of relief and sense of pleasure in the viewer. Yet the fragmentation and the blast of symbols remind us the pain of being bombarded in an overcrowded urban society.